Hello. I'm James Miranda. I'm going to be reading some original poetry and a few by some other artists as well. I'm going to start with a poem that's called Newborn American Poet. The delivery room is across state lines. I'm attending via cell phone towers, two bars, low battery through several time zones when I learn that I have bred a poet. Her first words, it's all your fault. She inks hieroglyphic tattoos across her vocal cords in flesh tones that read, I don't write, you know that. She was conceived immaculately since all poets are orphans in some sense of the word. She laments that it's my voice in her head. And when seeds are planted in her riverbed with adjectives like poetic, the two react. An interstellar engagement occurs and the clouds squeeze the sun into an hourglass to pour life into her new river where she tells the first person she's ever even considered the word love for that he smells like 3 a.m. driving with the windows open on clear nights with the music playing. I don't tell her. Much later that after hearing this, I spent the next 5 weeks trying to be up exactly that early on clear nights, driving with the windows open, music playing, soundtrack of all the songs I ever learned from Elle. This is not a love poem, exactly. I simply find it hard to disconnect myself from her when I find that it is my voice that speaks the new lines that her wrists so often refuse to construct. And perhaps because I tend to recite poems about things that are wrong, are going wrong, or generally bad things. She doesn't write poems about love. She writes anti-poems about question marks. Question marks and loving them hard, because grounding yourself with something as heavy as language is harder than simply not knowing. And none of us really have the patience to sift through the moment-by-moment portrait of another's exact emotional situation like love was even as simple as percentages. You'll be glad to know that 78% of the time he's thinking of you, 90% of those thoughts are positive. The other 22 divide amongst food, sleep, the money he owes, and his dreams. P.S. 86.5% of all statistics have been made up. But now, when the verses scar paper, the marks taste sweet of her words and mine. Like we were switched at birth, or in a moment of absolute clarity, I remember us simultaneously killing one another in a past life, and as amends, it is only right that we should build together in this one, with DNA strands like cosine waves binding us at the pen, and yet still there is a note of bitter with this sweet, as only starvation summons forth these symphonies to grace in lieu of distilleries, the lips of Elle, newborn American poet.